Hey everyone, I hope you're all doing well. As you can see, I'm sitting in front of my bookshelf, so I'm here with another book-themed video. So what I want to talk today about is unread books, and specifically the books that I have on my bookshelf that I haven't read. Now, currently, that number is only 11, which I think is pretty good. At one point, I think I had around like 50 unread books. I could have had more at one point. I think at one point I just was like buying books but not reading as much. So I had like all these unread books. And at the point that I actually counted, now I'm like really count and keep track of this stuff, it was around 50. So I think at one point it was definitely more. But yeah, that's one of my tips. If you have a lot of unread books or you feel like you do, like just take an inventory of your books and see how much you have that is actually unread. It will give you like a wake-up call or be like, okay, I feel okay about it. Because it definitely did give me a wake-up call when I started counting it out and realizing how many unread books I have. So the past like few years, I've been really making it a point to kind of get through my stack of unread books. So I've always had, last 3 years, I've had a book goal to finish 50 books in a year. So in 2012, I had the goal to read 50 books. I only read 37, so I didn't meet my goal. Then 2013, I had the same goal again. I only read 42 books. And then this past year, I have had the same goal again. And currently, I've read 49 books. So considering it's only November, I only have to read one more book, I definitely think I will be meeting that goal this year. So that's super exciting. But that has definitely helped me get through a lot of my unread books, is just making a reading goal. I document it in my little notebook here, my unread book, or not my unread books, but the books that I read. So it definitely has been keeping me motivated to read and kind of get through my unread books. With having unread books, I haven't really limited my book buying, but now I tend to buy only several times a year, and I'll buy like quite a few books at once versus just continually buying books throughout the year. I feel like that has helped me like really think about the books I want to buy. I try to look on Amazon, look up reviews, see like books that are recommended to me, versus just kind of buying books like when I go to Target or, you know, grocery store, or like just buying books on impulse. I try now to like really look at reviews and really think about what I'm buying versus just impulsively buying things. Because I think that's what got me into a lot of trouble, is just like impulsively buying things and ending up with more than I actually needed. So I did want to go over the 11 books that I have that are unread. Of the 11, 6 of the books I've had for years. I've had these books, I'm not sure how long I've had all the books, but I want to say I've had these books around, you know, anywhere from like 4 to 6 years. So they're books that have been sitting unread for a long time. And then the other 5 books I'm not as worried about. They're books that I've gotten this year. So I feel like if you can read your books like within a year, that that's pretty good. But stuff that's been sitting for years and years and years, that's not the place that I want to be. So I'm going to show you my unread books. I tried to figure out how long I've had these books for. I was only able to figure that out for a few of them. I was able to go on Amazon. If you order on Amazon, you can actually go and see your purchase history. I think I could do it for like the last 10 years. But some of these books, I'm not actually sure if I bought on Amazon. I tried to look on Barnes & Noble too, but it only shows up to like 18 months. So I was only able to figure out dates for a few of these, but this is probably, well, the one that I can document as being my oldest unread book. This one I had purchased, September 4th, 2008. This is by Jodi Picoult, and this is Keeping Faith. So if you can see behind me, I have a lot of Jodi Picoult books. A few years ago, I was really into her books. I was getting them from the library. Like, I will get into an author and I will feel like I need to read every book by the author. So I was getting stuff from the library, stuff they didn't have in the library. I had it on my Amazon wish list. And either through the library or through buying books, I listened to some of her books on audiobook. I like acquired all of her books or read all of her books or had the intention to read all her books. So this is one by her that I have not read yet. I also have Perfect Match by Jodi Picoult that I have not read yet. And I also have Picture Perfect by her that I have not read yet. So yeah, I have three books left by her that I have not read that I own. She has come out with a few more books more recently, but I've told myself I can't buy any more books by her until I read the ones that I already have, just so I don't accumulate more and more and have that same like author addiction. Once I get through these books, and if I decide I want to buy more from her, I can, but I did limit myself in that way. And it wasn't just her. I had a few other authors. Currently, I've gotten through these. This is my last remaining like multiple books by same author, unread in my unread pile. But I did have quite a few books by similar authors that I hadn't gotten through. So these ones, three more to get through. If you haven't read Jodi Picoult books, her books are all kind of like bestsellers. She's a very popular author, but she writes very kind of intense stories. She writes about a lot of controversial topics. Her books usually have some sort of like courtroom sort of drama. Usually her books have multiple characters, so it focuses on different characters. I feel like her books are very, very good, very like deep topics, so you feel you kind of have to be in the mood to read her books. But they also have a lot of detail, and sometimes they can be a little, like, take a little longer to read through. They're not necessarily beachy quick reads. So three books to read by her, but I really do love her books, so I am excited about that. I just tend to only read a few books by her in like any given year. So the other long-standing unread books I have. This is The Time Traveler's Wife. This is by Audrey Niffinger. So I've had this book since August 8th, 2009. Now I got this book because of the movie. And I'm not really sure. I think the movie came out in 2008. I have the DVD. It said 2008. So I'm not sure if I watched the movie and then I'm like, well, let me read the book. Or I bought the book and then I'm like, well, let me watch the movie. Usually with books to movies, I really prefer reading the book first and then watching the movie. Once I watch the movie, I feel like the book's a little bit spoiled. So I never really got into reading this book because I did watch the movie first. And this book is just heavy. I think it's over 500 pages. So it always just feels like something that, oh, it's going to take me a while to read. And I've already watched the movie. But at this point, I haven't seen the movie in quite a few years. So I think I can pick it up at this point and not really know what's going to happen. So that is another long-standing unread book. And then I have this one. This is Everything Nice. This is by Ellen Shanman? This one, I think I got it Rite Aid. It's just a mass market paperback. You know how drugstores or grocery stores will have their book section with a lot of just like paperback books? This was only $5.99, so I'm sure I just bought this on kind of impulse. It was inexpensive. That's what really got me into trouble, is buying books impulsively. So that is something I'm trying not to do anymore. And then this book I've had for a long time. This is The Friendship Test by Elizabeth Noble. Now this one, you can see it has a little Sharpie mark at the bottom. So this one, it was a few years ago that I got this. This is when all the bookstores like Borders was going out of business and some other bookstores were going out of business. And I got this at one of like the sales for like bookstores going out of business. I got quite a few books from those bookstores going out of business sales. Just because something's on sale and you're like, ooh, it's cheap. Oh, I've heard of this author before. I'm sure you'll love it. That got me into trouble. So, yeah, definitely now when I buy books, I try to, like, have a list. I have my Amazon wish list. I try to, like, look up reviews and try to really make sure it's something I really want to read versus just buying it because it's cheap or, oh, it looks like a cool book. So that is something that I'm trying to do now. So those are six books that I've had for years and years and years. So my goal is just to finish them in the upcoming year. I'm not going to make it like I have to finish these books in the next 2 months. I do like kind of mixing up what I read. You know, if I'm reading something that I've had for a long time, there's probably a reason why I've had it a long time. You know, the books that you've had a long time, obviously they've had years and years to catch your interest and they haven't. They look either intimidating or long or something about them. It just doesn't make you super want to read them right away versus like newer books that you're like, ooh, this just came out. I really want to read it. So I don't want to try to force myself to finish these in a small amount of time, but I think a year is plenty of time. It would be about reading one of these books about one every 2 months, which I think is definitely doable and not overwhelming. So that is my goal for next year with regards to these books. And I do have 5 other unread books, but like I said earlier, these are all books that I have gotten, I think this last summer. Like, I think I got most of these in July of this year, so I haven't had them that long. I definitely think that some of these I will be able to finish this year, I think, and definitely it won't be a challenge for me to finish the remaining books next year. But I do want to finish these books next year, or at least by the end of next year as well. So I'll go over which books of these I have. This one I actually got from my brother's girlfriend. She lives in New York, and she had stuff at her grandma's house, and she was going through boxes, and she was going to get rid of this, but she's like, hey, like, do you guys want to, like, she asked my family if we wanted to go through some stuff, and this is Lady Alamina and the Real Downton Abbey. So I really like Downton Abbey, the TV show, so I thought this would be fun to read, like, when Downton Abbey comes back. And I think, I'm not really sure when it's coming back this year, but it's usually on in, like, January or, like, the winter time. So I should be reading this in the next few months. I think that will be fun to read. And then I have 4 other books. So this is The Hypnotist Love Story by Leanne Moriarty. So these next few books, I got all of these on Book Outlet, so you can see the little Sharpie mark on the bottom. So Book Outlet has book, it's a website, and they have books like from a few years ago that were popular, and sometimes they're ones that have been like slightly damaged or sitting in book on like warehouse shelves or like overstock type of books. Then you can get for a discount. So I do recommend, if you are thinking about making an Amazon order, checking out Book Outlet and seeing if you can get some of the books that you've been wanting for lower prices. So I have this one, and I've listened to a few audiobooks of books by this author. Currently, I'm listening to Big Little Lies by this author, and I've also listen to The Husband's Secret, which I really liked. So I'm excited. It's my thing again. If once I like read something by an author or listen to audiobook of an author, I'm like, I have to read more by the author. So I have this book by her. I also have this. This is If You Lived Here, You'd Be Home Now. This is Claire Lezebnik. So I have read other books by this author. I really enjoy this author's books. This is another one that I will want to read soon. And then a Sarah Peckham novel. I've read all the other books by Sarah Peckham, but I haven't read this one. This is Skipping a Beat. And then if you've been reading or watching my book wrap-ups lately, I've always been including a Pretty Little Liars book. I've been trying to get through this series. There's 16 books in the series total, and the final book's going to be coming out in December. This is book number 15. So this one I'm planning to possibly read this month or in December, just so I can get through this series. So this is Toxic by Sarah Shepard, in the 15th book in the Pretty Little Liars series. So those are all of my unread books. So I definitely plan to be reading these books by the end of next year, and I plan to continue with my monthly like reading wrap-ups. So definitely you should be seeing these books in upcoming reading wrap-ups. If you've read any of the books that I mentioned and you really enjoyed it, please let me know, because it will get me excited to read some of these books that I've had for a long time. And I would love to know if you have a lot of unread books and if you have a plan to kind of get through them. So thanks for watching and have a nice day. Bye.